Being the holiday season, not a lot to really report on. We've had a couple of times we had a little skip or snow or two, and so we dealt with that. We've got some incidents. We have had a lot of cold temperatures, as everybody knows, and I'd just kind of like for benefit of everybody, just kind of touch a little bit on about how did they affect us on the cold temperatures deal on the gravel roads. Gravel roads are the type of surface that, you know, obviously they change compared to your regular paved road. Summertime, as I mentioned before, you're dealing with the dust, a lot more of the washboarding, those types of things. In the wintertime, dealing more with the freeze-thaw. And definitely, I think we've all noticed that we've been in pretty good freeze here the last week or so, a couple of weeks. And so, what we've been having right now, the roads, we had some there, Chad, in your area there that we worked on. We put a little bit of spot gravel and things on them. They're pretty packed down and frozen right now. We can't really get a motor grader back on to work them. The concern of seeing the slums to talk about with putting more gravel on them is kind of hard to get the gravel to stick onto it, kind of like putting it on ice right now.
I understand that.
And so asking them to do, I've instructed them to do, talking with them earlier today, is I want them to make sure that we kind of stay on top of the freeze thaw, and whenever we start getting some conditions that we do have more of that fallout, that we look to get some gravel on some of those roads to address.
Well, they need it.
Address some of that during that time. And then, of course, we get some snow, we'll be adding gravel for traction and so forth that. That's kind of how we're dealing with those. But we do have the list. I'm going to keep the list out there in forefront. I've talked to Mr. Byington and the Air Maintenance Manager of Jonesville. We're going to try to make sure that those get some attention. And again, the thing we have is if right now they're frozen, in some ways, the good part is that if you get ones packed down, they ride pretty good to a certain degree. But if you get any kind of frozen precipitation on them, then they're going to get slick pretty easily. And we have to add for stone for traction. But it also, if they start getting washboardy or getting potholes and things in there, it makes it difficult because it's so frozen that the motor grader won't get down it.
Well, I mean, I understand that now. I mean, it'd be, you know, pointless to try to grade them. You couldn't grade them now, but what I'm saying is, you know, the initial request was on December 7th. Mm-hmm. So up until the past 5 or 6 days, we had some time there to perform some of these things.
I think that we're going to work on it. When I talked with them, they've said they put some gravel down in on spots. As they're saying, we probably got a little different interpretation how much gravel needs to be put on, but we'll work on seeing what we're
doing. The entire road, it's not the spots.
Yeah. It's sometimes difficult to get it down on the entire road, but we're going to work on seeing.
I mean, that's part of it. When you got gravel road, that's part of why you have a maintenance budget.
We do. And that budget is very restricted on what we can do. But we will try to work to address it.
Okay.
That really, I think, covers most of what that I had to report to you on as far as specifics. You have on your agenda about the Route 682 bridge, and I was going to address that a little bit, talk to Mr. Starnes for the meeting, just to kind of give you a little overview about what's going on with that project.
Okay.
And whenever you're ready, but we can take questions or anything there that you all But can you, I was gonna discuss it all in general there.
Okay.
I approve.
Go right ahead.
Do you wanna touch on, see if anybody else has got anything else first before I go into that?
I do have one comment that VDOT's doing, on this bush hogging with that extended arm, I'm gonna pick up on the banks with it. I don't think I'm up that idea, but it's good. It's the great 72 they done it, and it looks great in doing that, so. Anyway, I compliment you all for doing that. It makes the roadways, the biggest thing with the deer, you can see them come out of the shit.
We're trying to push them back as much as we can next time.
Well, it looks good what they're doing.
Where is this Route 682?
It's in Copper Creek. It's in the eastern, northeastern kind of area off of 612. Comes in off 71. 71, like toward Russell County. Little Duck's up on the Russell County side, yes, but it comes off of 71 and back. It's called Copper Creek on.
I think it's that road up to Russell County line almost that comes back down and hits into Little Duck.
It does.
It comes down that Ryan Sluss's farm in there. On that back road in there.
More Alligator City on 662. Probably like a mile or three quarters from the bank there. There's been a lot of big trucks in front of it, and that bank is deteriorating. It's getting eat up in the road.
Okay, go check it out.
It's right, there's a cemetery there on the right hand side, just you go around there.
Okay.
People's getting, they don't wanna get over on account of the bank, and it's getting real dangerous.
Is it on the lower side or the upper side?
It's on the lower side.
Okay.
On the left hand side going out.
Okay, all right, we'll get it checked.
For the benefit of the people in the county who watch these meetings, in the event of a pretty significant snowfall, how are we set for road maintenance during snows this year? Is that gonna be contracted out, or who works the roads, and do you have people to work them, and are people gonna be waiting a while, or do you think the primary roads gonna get worked pretty quickly, or how's that?
I don't think we should see any change as far as when it comes to our snow removal budget. We don't have any plan change with that. The way we accomplish that is we use a mix of our state forces and contractors to take care of the roadways. We work the primary roads first, and then as we get the primaries cleared, then we move on to the higher volume secondaries and then on down into the lower volumes. We have split day and night shifts. The exact number of trucks, I'm not sure. Jackie, do you know how many? Here, I always think in terms of the entire residency, about how many we've got.
Each headquarters got about 8 to 10.
Of our trucks, but we bring in probably about another 10, probably in contractors to use to supplement those during that time. We don't ever turn completely over to contractors and not have our guys out there, but we have, our headquarters are staffed by around 10 to 12 people, so we split those guys up into two different shifts, and then we use the contractors along with that, whereas with plows and sprayers, and then it's like during the snows that we have had just recently, which have not been much, we have had at times 2 to 3 people out each night, just in order to monitor bridges and slick spots that there might be. And then, like on Christmas Day, we had folks out, Christmas Eve, Christmas Day, we had folks out working, and they worked 1 to 2 o'clock those days dealing with the little snow that we got then. We have various levels of mobilization that we go through. If we have kind of a watch, then we have some of just mainly our folks out checking roads. We go up into a very small inch or so of snow. We may bring in contractors to help us get to cover the routes. And then when we have very good old-fashioned plowing snow, then we bring contractors in with plows and sprayers and assign those to work with our routes too. We have trucks on every primary route that that time, and then, and on some cases, some of the higher volume secondaries. And then after that, if we need to, we also have on standby, we have loaders, tractors, motor graders, all those types of resources that we can draw in to help us remove the snow. But to answer your question, as far as our snow budget, when I mentioned to you and talked to you in recent months about the status of our maintenance budget, that's our regular routine, our emergency operations budget is not changed. We will do what's necessary to get the roads clear.
Thank you, sir.
First last year, I had some complaints when it was plowing snow. When it was plowing, they was jerking those reflectors up. That's in the center of the road.
Mm-hmm.
And so some people had some flats. Is there something that caused them to come over it?
Well, those are put down into the road with, you know, they're put in with an epoxy that's in there. The biggest thing that happens with those is, like when you start having the pothole or the, you know, soft spot comes into the pavement, it weakens around that epoxy, and that's whenever they pop out. It's kind of, we try to keep a watch on those, but it's just a deterioration of the asphalt that kind of just happens with normal wear and tear, and sometimes the snowplow blade will catch them and pop them out.
This was up in the Taylor Town area that I got the plates on. That section's been repaved now, so I guess it's...
And we try to address the pavement markers through big part whenever we repave the road, putting them back in, but we have, in the last 2-3 years, have had a maintenance program where we're actually just going out and replacing Lindsay's and some of those things there like that with them. Does anybody have anything else for me, Jeremy, before I discuss the... Talk about the bridge.